Monday, April 6th. I hope that you all had a wonderful, restful, productive weekend of sheltering at home. I began painting my kitchen, and like most home improvement projects that I'm involved with, I was enormously successful in lowering the overall value of my home by several thousand dollars in just under 3 hours. On the bright side, I was able to watch Terms of Endearment, The Squid and the Whale, and A Marriage Story. Those movies are hilarious. Before we get to the show, we'd like to try to get the word out for some help from our community during this COVID-19 crisis. As many of you have heard, last Friday, the Center for Disease Control began recommending that everyone wear cloth face coverings in public settings. As you know, there is a terrible shortage of masks to go around for medical personnel and essential workers, both around the nation and in our community. Over the last 2 weeks, the costume shops and costume supervisors, both at SLO REP and Cal Poly Theater, have made hundreds of masks to distribute to those that need them. However, our community could use your help as well. If you have the time, the equipment, and the supplies to build masks during this shelter-at-home period, please contact us at kevin@slorep.org. Instructions from the CDC on how to create these masks can be found at the link provided right below my face or on our website. Thank you so much for your help with this, and we hope to hear from you very, very soon. We have a great show for you. Today's Artist Spotlight will feature America's treasure, Mike Mesker. Carrie DiMaggio will be joining us with the very first ACT Spotlight assignment for our young actors. We'll have a shelter at home report direct from Ashland, Oregon, featuring the incredible Natasha Harris. And we'll wrap up with some very important updates based on audience feedback we received from our first show. So, let's get this ball rolling with our very first Artist Spotlight segment featuring everyone's favorite man in chair, America's treasure, Mr. Mike Mesker.
Hello, my name is Mike Mesker. I've been performing at SLO REP for around 20 years now. The last thing you might have seen me in is The Fantastics. I played Henry the Old Actor. Prior to that, I was Marcus Lycus in A Funny Thing Happened on the Way to the Forum. And you might remember me as Roger Elizabeth Debris in The Producers. I try to do a show there as often as possible. If I'm fortunate enough to get cast, you'll see me. I like to challenge people who have the means, like me, to donate. I've decided to donate all the money I would have spent on gas to SLO REP, and I'm saving a lot by not going to work every day. So every 2 weeks when I get my paycheck, I'm making a donation to SLO REP, and I challenge you all to do the same if you are able to. I just love SLO REP, and I hope you do too, and I hope you continue to support it. And thank you, Kevin, for trying to do something during this really frustrating time, but it's also a good time to kind of reflect on what's important in life, and for me, theater is really important in life. Okay, take care, everybody.
Thank you so much, Mike. We miss you, my friend, and we can't wait to see you back up on this stage very, very soon. All right, young actors, here comes your first assignment from Carrie DiMaggio. It is time for our ACT Spotlight.
Carrie, welcome to ACT Spotlight. We're going to kick off the ACT Spotlight series with an acting challenge. And since I know that you guys have all been practicing social distancing, we are going to be acting with a monologue, which is where one person is speaking or making a speech. I've put together a collection of monologues at slorep.org, and I want you to choose one and record yourself performing it. I've also put together some acting tips for you guys, including the 5 important questions that you're going to want to ask yourself when you're working on a monologue that will help make your performance really great. Any of the monologues can be performed by girls or boys, so just choose the one that you like the best. Make sure to check out the acting tips worksheet and also the tips for filming your monologue. And when you're done, follow the link to upload your video. And make sure to get it to us by Friday for the chance to be featured on the next SLO REP The Intermission Show. Okay, ready to get started? Head over to slorep.org for all of the details. I can't wait to see what you guys put together. Stay creative and have fun.
Thank you so much, Carrie. Now listen up, young actors. We'll be showing some of your completed work on this Friday's show. So please make sure to upload your video to the link provided on our website no later than this Thursday at 3 p.m. That's this Thursday, April 9th at 3 p.m. We cannot wait to see what you've come up with. And now let's switch gears for our daily shelter at home report. All right, let's just boot up our patented shelter at home machine. It's raining a bit outside and this thing gets really finicky in the rain because of all the complicated machinery and circuits and internets that it needs to in order to function properly. So let me just put in the coordinates for Ashland, Oregon here. Yep. That all seems to be working great. Let me just dial this in. Gotta dial it in. All right, ladies and gentlemen, there she is. It is Natasha Harris.
Hi, my name is Natasha Harris. I am an actor who's worked on the Central Coast for a handful of years, both at the Great American Melodrama and at PCPA. I'm currently in Ashland, Oregon, sheltering in place, spending my time running and drawing and cooking and laughing and grieving and talking on the phone and watching The Tiger King. You know the basics. I'm currently part of the cast of Spitfire Grill up at Oregon Cabaret, and today would have been our opening. I'm grateful for the journey I've had to work on Spitfire Grill, even if folks may or may not get to see it at this moment, at this hour. I'm super grateful for the friends I've made, the music I've gotten to play, the skills I've improved with the instruments I play. And I think sharing gratitude has kept me emotionally and mentally healthy. So I choose gratitude. Let's see, one of my special skills on my resume, if you insist, I can recite the first sentence of Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone in Russian. So here we go. Мистер и миссис Дерсл проживали в доме номер 4 по Тизовой улице и всегда с гордостью заявляли, что они, слава богу, абсолютно нормальные люди. I doubt that's ever going to get me a job, but we'll see if people ever get to that, the end of my resume, when they read it. Stay safe out there, stay healthy, and stay grateful.
Thank you so much for checking in from Ashland, Oregon, Natasha. We miss you and hope to see you very, very soon. Finally, after last Friday's episode, the SLO REP Intermission Show team was somewhat surprised to receive a significant amount of feedback, both private and public, expressing concern about the mental state of Jeff Salisbury during his shelter at home segment. The outpouring of messages was a bit troubling, and so we feel that it is our responsibility to provide a quick follow-up report to put everyone's mind at ease. In last Friday's segment, Jeff was doing what we in the theater business call a bit. A bit is simply a joke, played with some sincerity. A bit is a comedic take on reality. A good example of a pretty solid bit from last Friday's segment was when Jeff was admiring a large paper model of the Empire State Building he had built during lockdown, only to reveal a smaller paper model of the exact same building perfectly hidden behind the larger one. Truth be told, Jeff submitted over 12 minutes of video to the Intermission Show. These 12 minutes are chock full of bits, including such classics as standing up to reveal you are not wearing any pants, pretending that you are a robot, and an extended scene between Jeff and a sock puppet.
He's very shy. Roscoe, can you say hi? Okay, Roscoe, what if I promise to not put you on my feet anymore?
The point is, as you can clearly see, Jeff is doing just fine, and there's no reason at all to worry about him. And everyone here at the Intermission Show apologizes if we missed the mark. Jeff is, like all of us, trying to navigate this strange new reality in the best way that we know how. And occasionally, The best way is by filming yourself talking to a sock puppet for 3 minutes and sending it into a YouTube show. We feel you, buddy. We feel you. That'll wrap up today's episode of the Intermission Show at SLO REP. For more information about the show or to access all assignment materials for our ACT Spotlight, please check out the links in the description below on YouTube or visit slorep.org. For the latest information on the COVID-19 crisis in SLO County, please visit readyslo.org. Thank you, as always, to all of our essential workers, medical personnel, and city officials who are working around the clock to try to bring normalcy back to our community. Stay safe, happy, and healthy, everyone. Hug the people that you're allowed to hug, and see you in a couple of days.